friends, today we shall perform a practical to measure the inductor's inductance L and verify series and parallel rule for the inductors. In the same way, we can perform to measure the capacitors, and verify series and parallel rule. The circuit and practical arrangement and the aptitude to perform the practical, in both practicals are the same. So let me draw a simple circuit to measure how to measure the inductor's inductance or capacitor's capacitance. Only thing is that instead of capacitor or an inductor, we are replacing to each other. So let us see the circuit. Very simple circuit. We are providing AC supply. This is a variable AC supply and one series current meter. This is also an AC series current meter. This will be given to the supposed inductors L and the parallel. There is an AC voltage meter. So just you apply different AC voltage corresponding to that voltage, you will find out across the inductor voltage, AC voltage as well as AC current. In the same way, this performance you can shift for the capacitors. Suppose you have the capacitors and we can measure capacitors capacitance also in this aptitude. The same arrangement, everything is the same. So first we shall measure two inductors, L1 and L2's inductance, and then we shall verify series and parallel rule. In the same way, we can measure two capacitors, the capacitance C1 and C2, and ultimately we will find out verifications of the series and parallel rule. Okay, thanks. Now, you see, this is your observation table aimed to determine inductors, inductance and verification series and parallel combinations or connections. The apparatus are AC variable power supply, inductors X and Y. That means you are using two inductors, AC current meter and AC voltmeter, as earlier we did. Now, this is the expressions and very simple formula to define the XL is equal to 2 pi FL. That's why the L is equal to XL by 2 pi F. And our frequency throughout this practical is 50 Hertz constant. This is the circuit arrangement what we did earlier for the capacitors. Now capacitor is replaced by the inductor. Only thing is that. Now observation table. See the observation table. It is also remaining the same what we did earlier. Only capacitors replaced by inductor. Right, and this is the last one, observation table. Clearly mentions on the observation table that it is for the parallel connection, parallel connections. Okay, let me start experiment. Right, okay, let us start with the experiment. Providing AC voltage, different AC voltage. The series arrangement of this circuit, you see, current meter to the inductor, inductor's second terminal goes to the supply, series connection is over, and multimeter is connected parallel, right? And it will work as an AC voltmeter, this multimeter. Let me on this multimeter. So it is a digitally. So naturally it will take some fluctuations. But 4.6 volt is a confirm. And this is the current which shows 1.6 milliampere. So let me write down that our current
and voltage. Let us take second reading, giving different kind of the voltage. Okay, you see current 2.24 milliampere and voltage is 7.25. So voltage is 7.25, current 2.4 milliampere. Milliampere is indicated here, and here is indicated voltage, and this is the reactance. That means it is in terms of ohm. This is also in terms of ohm, and ultimately we will find out the Henry, that means inductor inductance in terms of Henry. So you can understand how to write observations, right? So let us provide me one more reading, and that is your current meter. It shows 3.2 and voltage 10.04. voltage is 10.04 or 10.02. okay, let me write 10 only, 10.0. that means, so this will be the and current 3.2. you see, this is your worksheet is completed for the reading of the voltage and current for the different applied AC source voltage. So you can understand, this is the voltage and current. Just you can find out XLS by the simple calculations, voltage divided by current, current in terms of milliampere. So 10 to corner of minus 3 goes to over, that will be 10 raised to plus 3. So we can calculate even our Henry, right? So I got the mistake. That mistake is that I have written all these observations and I simply defined the L1 and L2 inductors. It should be mentioned here, right? It should be mentioned here, voltage for L1, voltage for L2, milliampere for L1, L2. And here I have connected that inductor, the name is L1. So let me change these observations, and I would like to write here. So now you can understand, this is voltage and current for the L1 inductors, and then we will connect the L2, do the same performance, and will mention here L2. L2 voltage and current. So one observation table included measurement of the inductance of the L1 and L2, right? So I will show here how the reactance I have calculated, that you know very well, that the voltage divided by current. So this voltage divided by current, you will find out the reactance of the inductance. Okay, let me write down. Okay, now you see, I have calculated reactance of each voltage and current. That is 2.93, 3.1, 3.1, 3 and 2.9 kilo ohms. Exactly, it shows average value 3.0 kilo ohms. So I will use this expressions, define the inductance of this inductor, that is L1, is equal to define the reactance average value divided by 2 pi F, right? So my inductance of this inductor will be L1 is equal to 3 kilo ohms divided by 3.14 multiplied by 50. This equal to 3 kilo ohms divided by 314. The multiplications of the three term is 314. So let us calculate the value. 3 divided by 314, that is 3 divided by 314. Okay, there is some errors. So three kilo ohms divided by 314, and it shows a kilo, that means it is 10 to corner of 3s, and 3 divided by 314, that is 0.0095. so 10 to corner of 3s, that means it shows 9.5 Henry. So I would like to say it is almost 10 Henry, but we shall calculate and use this real value what we have obtained here, that is 9.5 Henry, right? But it is almost, you can say, 10 Henry. And already I have connected 10 Henry's inductor, right? So not to worry about this result. It's a good result. Start with the L2, that means a different inductor. And this I have connected here, the same circuit arrangement, series arrangement. And you see I have provided a voltage, and the current it shows 1.5 milliampere, while voltage it shows 4.78. Now let me change status of the AC voltage source. This will be the different, and that is why the current it shows 2 milliamperes and the voltage it shows 7.47. okay, that I will mention here in my observation table. You can see this is the second inductor voltage and current, voltage, and this is the current, this voltage and this current. Okay, now I would like to change one more reading and change the AC source. So this will be the 10.27 voltage, as well as 3 milliampere is the current status. So you can take several reading. This is a fourth one, and you can say it is a 4 milliampere, and voltage shows 13.8. okay, further I can finish this voltage, and this is the voltage, this is the status of the current with the different AC voltage here, and last one. So this will be your current, your voltage, which I have mentioned here. This voltage and this is the current. Okay, now I will take reactance, right, here, and then average of the both the reactance here, right? So let me I have fill up set of observations that the voltage of the second inductor L2, and that is the current with respect to voltage. Take the ratio, that means you have the reactance, that value of that 3.17, 3.7, 3.41, 3.12, and ultimately 3 kilo ohms. So let us take the average value. This will be 3.28 kilo ohms. So we have defined the inductor's reactance. Earlier we did reactance, that was a 3.0 kilo ohms, and now this is 3.28 kilo ohms. So let me put the value in the equations of the inductor inductance. That equations is basically XL upon 2 pi f is equal to L2. So I have the value 3.28 kilo ohms and 2 pi f, that means it is a 314. So ultimately, once you divide 3.28 divided by 314, the value is 0.010. Obviously, k, that means 10 to corner of 3, is remaining as it is. And that is why our value of the cap inductor, that is at 10.0 Henry. So we could define two inductors inductance. Earlier L1, that was 9.5 Henry, and now L2, that is a 10 Henry. In each case, we use almost 10 Henry. So our result is very good. We could observe this value by the experimental aspect. Now, just you did this experiment in a series and parallel connections. So in the case, we both inductor will be utilized in our circuit. Okay. Now you see, this is the series arrangement of the two inductors. L1 connected with the different L2, which is in series. As you know, this terminal goes to power supply. Power supply, first terminal suppose goes to current meter. Current meter, the second terminal goes to inductor, and this is the series combinations. Obviously, this voltmeter is parallel to both inductors, right? Both are parallel. You can see it, you can visualize it. First terminal, you can say this is second terminal of the voltmeter, and let us start to note the reading. With the same way earlier, what we did in each and every case, the manner of the reading is the same. Suppose I provide the AC voltage and the current is a 0.8 milliampere and your voltage is 4.7. Now you provide different voltage AC and measure the current, that is a 1.2 milliampere and your voltage is 7.43, right? And then further up to a 6 different voltage categories, AC source, power supply, 6 readings. We have that facility and we are utilizing. This is 1.6 milliampere and this is the 10.24. So several readings, rest of, you can take it. And now I have taken that reading in a worksheet for the series connections. You see, you can take even the screenshot also. I have that different voltage measured and that different current. Take the ratio 4.8 divided by 0.8 milliampere. Ultimately, it is a 6 kilo ohms. And then 6.22, 6.40, 6.25, 6.37 and 6.46. And suppose I take the average value of all these reactants, that will be 6.28 kilo ohms. And now let us see the theory. LS, that means series, L1 plus L2, it is a combination. That means it is a 9.5 and 10 Henry inductance earlier we defined. So it must be a 19.5 Henry. So practically what happened, once we connected in the series and ultimately we could measure the reactance in series inductance, reactance 6.28 kilo ohms. And let us put the value in a equations, that means XS series divided by 2 pi F. That means 6.28 kilo ohms divided by 314. So this division shows 0.0200 into 10 to corner of 3. Okay, that means it is a 10 to corner of 3. So ultimately it is a 20 Henry. So it is a very good result. Theoretically it shows 19.5 Henry. Practically we could measure 20 Henry. So now we will connect next part, that is the parallel part. So parallel combinations of the circuit. Okay. This is a parallel combinations. These two terminal of the inductor connected to these two terminal of the inductor and voltage, of course, parallel, right? And parallel connections, one terminal goes to the power supply first terminal goes to the current meter and current meter the second terminal goes to the parallel connections, right? Now let us start the reading. Suppose I provide the voltage and this shows 2.5 and 3 milliampere. This shows the 3 milliamperes and the voltage is 4.75. Just use different socket. That is shows 4.5 milliamperes. And voltage shows 7.45. So rest of reading also you can note easily by use of different voltage. And that shows the 6 milliampere and it shows 10.26 volt, right? So next reading I have written here that you can see it. This is a 13.80 volt and 8.5 milliampere, 16.5 volt, 11 milliampere, 8.12 and 18.5 milliampere. So it's a good visualized result. Let us calculate the X, that means reactance, parallel connections reactance. This will be voltage divided by current, voltage divided by current, voltage divided by current of the each term, and we will find out each reactance. Okay, I have taken all the observations. What I have shown here, this is voltage corresponding to current, which was noted down by us, right? So rest of voltage 13.80 and the current is 8.5 milliampere. So ultimately, we have the reactance, voltage divided by current, that is in terms of 1.6 kilo ohm, 1.7 kilo ohm, 1.7, 1.6 and 1.5. You take the average, that means it is a 1.6 kilo ohms. So our reactance of the parallel parallel inductance, that is 1.6 kilo ohms. And now what will be the theoretical aspect? That means suppose our inductance L1 and L2 both are connected parallel, then it will be the, as per the parallel rules formula, equivalent resistance like. So L1 multiplied by L2 upon L1 plus L2. So ultimately our defined capacitance was, sorry, our inductance was 10 and 9.5. So just you take the equivalent, that is 95.0 divided by 9.5, that is 4.9 Henry. So our theoretical aspect is telling that our parallel inductance must be a 4.9 Henry. Now what will happen? Our experimental result says 1.6 kilo ohms, that is the reactance of the parallel inductance. So we have the formula reactance divided by 2 pi f. 2 pi f, that means it is a 314. So 1.6 kilo ohms, our average value, divided by 314. Kilo, that means it is a 10 to corner of 3. And ultimately we have 0.005 into 10 to corner of 3. That means it is 5 Henry. So our experimental and theoretical result match very well. So and it is very good results. So we can mention our result here also, that L2 was a 10 Henry Rao, right? L1 19.5, L2 was a, and we could verify our experiment in a proper way and justify even though in a proper way. So let us write down, the results. Earlier I have mentioned somewhere, defined the results where I am finding that as sheets, but right now I am not getting. So okay. Results after completing the practical, L1 is equal to 9.5 Henry and L2 10 Henry. The series value, right? Series LS. That is 20 Henry. We could find out, right? And parallel LP, that is 5 Henry, right? While theoretical value LS, theoretical value was 19.5 Henry and practical value was 20 Henry, right? So you can mention line here. In the same way, practically we could measure and LP theoretical was 4.9 Henry. So now your practical is over. We could obtain very good results, right? And even though you can utilize the screenshot, each time you can utilize the screenshot, this is the result, even though you can find out the screenshot and you can study nicely. Okay, fine. Next, we are meeting. Next meeting will be performed next practical.